the station just when it was due. I must have read the morning paper going into town. Having gotten through the editorial, no doubt I must have frowned. I must have made my desk around a quarter after nine, with letters to be read and heaps of papers waiting to be signed. I must have gone to lunch at 12:30 or so, the usual place, the usual bunch. And still on top of this, I'm pretty sure it must have rained the day before you came. I must have lit my 7th cigarette at 2:30. And at the time, I never even noticed I was blue. I must have kept on dragging through the business of the day without really knowing anything. I hid a part of me away. At 5 I must have left. There's no exception to the rule. A matter of routine, I've done it ever since I finished school. The train back home again. Undoubtedly I must have read the evening paper then. Oh yes, I'm sure my life was well within its usual frame the day before you came. On TV. There's not, I think, a single episode of Dallas that I didn't see. I must have gone to bed around 10:15. I need a lot of sleep, and so I like to be in bed by then. Read a while, the latest one by Marilyn French or something in that style. It's funny, but I had no sense in living without aim the day before you came.